MySQL is a computer software which allows one user to connect and work with databases. In more details, a software like MySQL allows the definition, creation, querying, update, and administration of databases. The correct term for a software like MySQL is Database Management System, or DBMS. MySQL is not the only database management system available. Well-known database management systems include MySQL, PostgreSQL, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, SAP, IBM DB2. However, MySQL is the world's most widely used open source one and is a popular choice of database for use in web applications. Applications which use MySQL databases include Joomla, WordPress, and Drupal. MySQL is also used in many large-scale websites, including Google, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. When you access a MySQL database, that system is a client-server system. In a client-server system, there is a server and arbitrarily many clients which are connected to the server and communicate with it. The databases and the database management system, in our case MySQL, are stored on the server. The clients communicate with it through a standard language called SQL. In other words, the client sends a SQL query to the DBMS on the server. The DBMS interprets the query and sends the results back to the client. SQL is a standard programming language used to communicate with a database. Although SQL is a standard programming language, there are many different versions of it. Each DBMS has its own SQL dialect that may include extensions or variations to the standards. However, the most basic SQL statements are the same for all SQL dialects. As a result, once you have learned one of those dialects, for instance MySQL, you can easily learn the other ones. A database is a collection of data or informations that is organized so that it can easily be accessed, managed, and updated. Let's take a bookstore as an example. Bookstores keep details of all their books in databases. By querying a bookstore's database, you can retrieve information about the book's title, author, or ISBN. You can find out how many copies are available for that book and get price information. In 1970, Edgar Frank Code developed a model for a new type of a database called a relational database. By using the relational model, you can view and manipulate data in a way that is both intuitive and efficient. Today, relational databases are the standard for database applications. The model for a relational database states that data is stored in one or more tables. Each table consists of rows and columns. Let's have a closer look at it. This is a database. Imagine it as the representation of a bookstore. the data in a database are stored in one or more tables. You can think of each table as the representation of a single section of a bookstore, like science, adventure, fantasy, or literature. The fantasy table, for instance, contains the list of the books on the subject of fantasy, and so do the others. Each table can be viewed as a two-dimensional matrix consisting of rows and columns. Let's open the fantasy table and have a closer look at it. This is the fantasy table. These are its rows, also called records. These are its columns, also called fields. Each column represents one attribute of the book, such as title, author, total number of pages, ISBN, and price. You'll learn about the ID column in the next tutorials. Each row of the table represents one single book. The row with ID of 4, for instance, corresponds to this particular book. And the row with ID of 5, for instance, corresponds to another book, and so on. The intersection of each row and column stores a single value. During the next tutorials, you're going to learn how to manage, manipulate, define, and retrieve data in a database.